There's something both mystical and beautiful, and I'd also add hopeful, about being on the top of a mountain. I know our lector Shelley knows a thing or two about being on mountaintops, and perhaps some of you do too. But if you've never been up there, today the prophet Isaiah brings us up on that high ground. He takes us far away from the tough reality of human trials by saying, on this mountain, the Lord of hosts will provide, not just for some, but for all peoples. The prophet then goes on to list all that the Lord will provide. Things we love, a feast of rich food and choice wines, the removal of the veil over all nations, and the destruction of death. This reading is one of the most hopeful we could ever receive from God. It's celebratory. It promises eternal life, the end of sorrow, and so importantly, freedom from the reproach from God. And continuing with the positive mood, Isaiah tells us how people will respond to God's blessings. He tells us that we'll see that our prayers, our faith in God, wasn't in vain, that the Lord hears and answers our prayers. People who place their trust in God despite the tough times, including internal turmoil, will rejoice and say that the Lord has saved us. Well, today is certainly a mountaintop type of day in the Gospel from Matthew as well. It is the place where Jesus heals the lame and the blind and the deformed and the mute. It's where Jesus is moved with pity for the suffering of all, including their physical hunger. And so he feeds the great crowds as only he can. All this caused me to wonder, perhaps you too, how do we hear this message? How do we hear this word of God today? We've come into the house of the Lord, either by walking into the Father Peyton Center or online. We've made our way up to this mountaintop to be nourished in mind, body, and soul. What do we bring to the celebration of the word in the Eucharist? What do we have to have healed or strengthened? Is it our faith in God who cares? Is it the mind or body of a loved one or us who is ailing? Is it our trust in humankind to show compassion, especially for those in need? Our God is the God of Isaiah and David and Matthew and throughout all of history. As in generations of our ancestors and now in our lives, God's promise remains. That's why, no matter what we're facing, every time we go to Jesus, no matter how deep the valleys of life, we can always find a reason for hope, a reason to persevere, and a reason to love God and each other. For to paraphrase the prophet, the hand of the Lord rests upon our shoulders. He gives us what we need, what our families and friends need, today and every day. May God bless you and your families this holy day as we bring this mountaintop message of hope from God to those we love.